Hi, everybody. My name is Lee Honish. I am the former head loss mitigator for Indy Mac Bank's HELOC division, and I am the foremost leading authority on the subject of distressed properties in North America. I've been teaching real estate agents and investors for the last 14 or 15 years on how to work specifically with people who've missed one payment, 31 days at 5 p.m., all the way up until the bank takes the property over and what happens in between. That is the point of our company, Home Advocates. That is what I do. I have a 30 plus year background in banking. And over the last decade, I became one of the very best real estate marketers in North America. We have picked one very specific niche to apply my marketing to. Would it work for other things? Of course it would, right? I just don't like the competition, right? The thing that I push to all of you repeatedly: start your branding early, start your marketing early, start your positioning early, and continue to do that before the market has changed. And the reason I'm telling you that is the market has changed. Today, we're going to talk about this. The market has changed. First and foremost, for those of you who didn't take advantage of our previous prices, we had 66% off for people joining the program. And I said, until the market changes, you could invest in the program and save a lot of money. That is not the case. We have now reverted it back to the original price of what I wanted the program to be. You can go to homeadvocates.academy and sign up. It's a one-time investment fee of $49.97. That is a lifetime enrollment. We appreciate all of you that sign up and get involved. There's the brief commercial. What did you say, Derek? You didn't take down the other page? Hold on one second. What do you mean you didn't take down the other page? What do you mean it's still there? I mean, that's ridiculous. The market's already changed. We've already, and I'm recording. What is your logic on giving away the product at that price? That's a lifetime of marketing. Why are you sending out that link to everyone? I thought you took that page down. Why don't you have an answer for any of this? Wow. Moving forward. Apparently the homeadvocates.io page /event with discount links is still available, and Derek doesn't give a shit about what I think pricing should be. So I recommend that if you want to get involved in the program, you should do it before I get off this call so that I can go and delete stuff to keep him. I'll talk to Fred. Wow. He did talk to Fred, and that'll change right after the call. So if you're on this call and you were thinking about joining, I'd recommend it and take advantage of that link because I can't multitask and delete shit. Forgive me. The market's already changed. Let me get back to where I was. Those of you watching the video, I apologize. For those of you who don't know anything about me, I apologize. There won't be any links for you when this video's up. That happens. But for those of you that made it to the call and were thinking about joining, well, you'd be crazy not to use that link that he just sent out to everybody. There you go. Moving forward, the market has already shifted and changed. So 2 weeks ago, we talked about this. Zillow had stopped buying properties, right? Randomly, they just out of the blue, right? And now we've seen a string. I'm sure Marvin has seen this and a lot of my other students have seen this, sent me emails. Oh, they're not doing that because they don't have money or they can't adjust staff or any of the reasons. Everybody said the same thing. They're fearful of the market change, right? Does that make sense to everybody? I said it immediately when I saw the press release that it was obvious what they were doing. What wasn't obvious is what they did just a few days later. And we've talked about this over the last week. They turned around and started selling all their inventory in major metros off as quick as they can. Now, that isn't to say they're not holding in Miami and they're waiting things out. But in a bunch of markets at the moment, they are selling inventory. And I keep pointing to, they're doing it in Phoenix. Phoenix is like Las Vegas That means parts of California, they're selling their properties off below fair market value, below what they paid for them. They bought some of these properties as recently as a few weeks ago, and they're turning around and selling them. So let's just talk about this, because you guys will understand this, like real estate agents, right? Why wouldn't you just put it on at the price you paid for it and wait, right? It shouldn't take that long. You bought it for $100,000. Why wouldn't you list it for $100,000? I mean, it couldn't take more than what? Let's just go with days on market in, say, Phoenix, 23 days on the market. Why wouldn't you wait 23 days to get your money back, right? I mean, that's what all of you should be thinking from a logical perspective. Why wouldn't you just want to wait 30 days to get your capital investment back instead of selling it as is, cash out the back door at a substantial discount? Substantial. Like, they're literally substantially cutting and selling. Some of their properties have seen 66% market reductions. Like, crazy things are happening with their properties. So let's be logical about this. Okay. There are two things that are occurring. One of two things can be occurring. Only. These aren't things I think. These are things I know. There are only two reasons to do it. Number one, they're on the verge of filing bankruptcy. They're having cash liquidity issues. And the company's on the verge of exploding and dying. Okay. So they've decided that we're going to stop buying. We're going to sell off inventory. We're going to put more cash in the bank. That's what you do to keep a company solvent. That's a very CEO move. That's option number one. Okay. And for those of you on the live call, feel free to vote on which one you think it is. Or it's option two, the money-making, revenue-generating funnel that they've been running throughout the pandemic of buying, holding, pricing higher, that has also artificially inflated certain markets by doing it. Okay. They just stopped doing that altogether. And I've said this on other calls. They were making in markets between 5 and 20% consistently on that funnel. They stopped doing it, right? So option number two, what do you guys know about the market that you're just packing up your tent and you're getting the hell out of Dodge? Now, I don't need to be an asset manager. I don't need to be a trend reader. I don't need to be a brilliant marketing strategist. I don't need to be a guy who can create content. I don't need to be a guy who's created, you know, my greatest creation, which is now Red Marketing, which, as you guys heard the other day, is vastly superior to other forms of marketing. Those things don't matter. This is just logical. I am somebody who invests in the stock market. I am a regular blue collar or even a white collar guy who watches and reads the news. What do you think the message is when the Wall Street Journal puts out an article that Zillow's, and this is a fact, Zillow's no longer buying properties and they're selling off their existing inventory below fair market value? Now, there's a comment in the coaching section right now that says they got greedy and now they are panicked for fear of loss. That's an interesting comment, Inez. Let me take it a step further and tell you real investor thinking and real CEO thinking. Hey, we don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. Let's sell off all our inventory, or we have inside information because we do have that much market data, and they do, right? Same way I would at the bank with my own portfolio. I'd be able to look at a portfolio and I could tell you what the entire market's doing based on my portfolio. I have a set, Marvin votes for option two, by the way. So the smart move is sell everything, take the loss. By the way, that's good asset management. Take the loss, write it off. Take the loss, write it off. Let the market decline, right? Because we've started, anyone know what we started November 1st and why I wanted to change the prices? Tapering has started, right? Did anybody see what happened to the stock sector for Zillow and Redfin and truly all those companies? Anybody know this? What happened yesterday? Anybody know what happened to those stocks just a day or two ago? Anyone know? Marvin? You usually know these things. They lost money. Their stock prices went down. I don't think real estate agents will notice until, you know, it's bad. The crash started. I don't know what else you need me to tell you. And in response, what has the Fed done? Because they already know the crash has started. Does anybody know what the Fed, what's going on right now in lending? They dropped the interest rates. We were all the way up to 3.5. They dropped them back down again, 3.1. Why would you do that? You don't have a choice. And we're still not addressing the biggest elephant in the room. There are 4 million people who've missed payments, and that excludes, right? That excludes people who took a forbearance agreement. If you add those people to the mix, you're talking 5.5 million people in the United States. 5%, 5%, 5% default rate. We currently have more people defaulted and noted by Black Knight than in 2007. Fact, right? I don't tell you things I think or think where they're going. That's an issue. Forget that issue. Set that elephant in the corner of the room. We're not reporting to FICO. We can't raise the interest rates. Zillow selling everything off below fair market value. The company that was actually artificially inflating the market has stopped inflating the market. The Fed, in response, let's be honest about lending, the Fed, the bond market, X, Y, and Z. They're doing everything they can from this little hyperinflation moment we're walking through to not turn into a zero crash recession. And everybody's sticking a Band-Aid on everything. Yet there are still real estate agents who fundamentally believe that the real estate market isn't, and I'll say this again, so don't send me a damn email on it or I'm gonna lose my mind. Some markets will correct, some markets will flatten, right? But the bulk and the general perception of the market is a crash. Do you realize how hard it must be for damage control on a government level to keep mainstream news off of these stories, right? The only way you're going to find anything I'm talking about is by going on Google and reading the Wall Street Journal and reading the New York Times or reading the LA Times or reading a major online publication. But mainstream, wake up at 9 a.m. and watch the news, CNN or Fox, is not going to talk about the fact that we're crashing, okay? It will create panic. Nobody's working. These are facts. I'm not telling you anything that's happening in my head. These aren't invisible ghosts. This is 30 years of banking, and I go, I can't do any more than I've done than to tell you to prepare for what's about to happen. So that means if you're a real estate agent or you're an investor, you have to look at the options for getting deals if you're an investor, right? How do I get a property? If you're a real estate agent, you think people are going to want to sell traditionally when the market is declining in value? Like, that is some very naive, stupid real estate agent thinking of, oh, the market's fine and people still want to sell. It is difficult right now for a real estate agent to get a listing in general. That's just a simple fact, right? If you're not doing some form of innovative marketing like my RED program or the 12-step program, the Home Advocates 12-step program, or, you know, any of the campaigns we've created for you to work and get listings, because that's what we do. We help you get deals and listings, right? At the end of the day, all I ask, because our mission is to help 1 million homeowners, is that you do one thing at that first appointment before you worry about selling or buying and flipping or whatever it is you're going to do. Give them their 9 options. Give them their 9 alternatives to foreclosure. Let them make a decision. The reality is 8 out of 10 people you're going to meet have to sell their house. They're either going to sell it or the bank's going to sell it for them. And we're talking 5 million people. Okay. It's not even a percentage. I mean, it's minuscule compared to all the active listings. It's frustrating for me, right? And that's what I think you guys saw last Wednesday when I did that call. I'm frustrated with how naive real estate agents are again, and how I know for a fact, just like 2007 and 8, once it's mainstream, because that's what makes it real, right? It's when Fox or CNN tells you, which is bullshit. Fox or CNN are all controlled. Got it? I don't lean left. I don't lean right. They're both controlled. They control the story. Both of them. Both of them. Okay? All of them. You want to do your homework, go online and start looking at it. Start looking at the stories. Educate yourself. Be like Marvin, right? The reality, what I know, is that somebody in Zillow went and had a talk with someone like me and said, what do you think? And someone like me in Zillow said, stop buying, or how would that work in a bank, Lee? Stop making loans. Okay. This is a real asset manager. I'm going to break it down. Stop making fucked up loans. Okay. Stop buying properties without looking at them and doing them through your little computer generated whirly machine. Okay. Step one. Step two, sell everything and get all the cash you can. They have inventory. In a bank, what's that mean? All this outstanding debt, sell it off. Sell it to investors. Sell it back to the homeowners. Make a loan mod. Do a forbearance. I don't care. Get it out of here. So let's look at these two institutions side by side and see what they're doing. Wells Chase and B of A have stopped doing equity lines and tightened up their lending restrictions. Zillow has stopped buying everything that wasn't bolted down on God's green earth. Wells Chase and B of A are doing loan mods, forbearance agreements. They're not reporting shit to FICO. They're willing to make deals. They're doing cash outs. They're doing whatever they can think of doing to limit the bleeding on their end. What's Zillow doing? They're selling off their inventory. Do you see the parallel? Now, what more do you need to know about the direction of the real estate market? Well, the government's going to fix it. Government's fucking it up more. Forgive my French, but I don't know any other word, right? The more they interfere, and this is now historically three presidents deep, the more you interfere with the natural progression, it's probably even more than that. This probably goes back all the way to, I don't know. It's gone on forever. Like I was just thinking it right now and I go, probably goes back to Reagan. Nope, goes back further. Probably goes back to Nixon. Nope, I keep rolling it backwards in my mind. Every time the government interferes with the natural course of real estate, right? You create false bottoms. There you go. Creates false bottoms. For all of you who think Obama walked on water, right? He's the one who made you guys lose REOs. He's the one who brought in the investors. He's the one who created, you know, BlackRock. And people like him and turned real estate into a commodity, which created a false bottom, stopped the market, corrected it in 2010. Was it good or bad? I don't know. You have less inventory. And you guys all rolled over like a dog and showed your belly for that one. NAR didn't do a damn thing to stop it, right? You guys lost an entire sector of your industry in 2010. Nobody said boo. Oh, REOs just don't exist. They don't do it that way anymore. That's not true. It was cheaper and more effective to sell at bulk by the banks to investors, period. And here we are, sitting on a wave that's already coming over. If you're in Arizona, it's happening. Zillow's decreasing the value of properties right now. Now, there isn't a third option, which is Zillow is just an insane, crazy machine, and they intentionally plan to crash the markets so they can turn around and buy properties on even more of a discount. Anyone ever ponder that one? Do you have a devious enough mind to think like Dr. Evil or like Lee Honish? Right? Hard to believe I'm single, right? Yeah, I got to think of the worst case doomsday scenario all the time. It's not a really loving environment in a relationship. I have very few friends. My life is exactly what it is. Every time I trust somebody, it's not a good thing. This is officially a DTA market. Don't trust anything. I wouldn't trust anything the news says. I wouldn't. It has to be tangible at this point and forward. If you're a real estate agent or an investor and you want listings, you got to come see me. You got to see me. You got to get involved with me right now. I can't do any more than I've done. Everybody who's watching this video, you're already a part of my email list. You've been on the webinars. I don't know why you're sitting on the sideline. You got to get in the game, right? And to quote Tony Stark from the first Avengers movie, time to get you in the game, right? We got to get the Hulk in the game. And I need all of you to help me with my mission, which is to make a difference about the market. Take advantage of Derek, who, if I had the ability to fire him at this moment, I would. For those of you that are on the call live, I'll send that link that he just sent out, because that would be crappy if I didn't help out with that. I can't even believe it. Whatever. homeadvocates.io/event. There won't be a link in the email when I resend this out. homeadvocates.io/event/. At least until after golf. Now I'm booked. In fact, I'm doing an interview right after this with a couple of news publications, which is why I'm all dressed up. I'm dressed up because I enjoy it. Truthfully, I enjoy being the banker and thinking like a banker and not trusting anything that I'm seeing and knowing that the market crash is crashing. The problem is you guys want to believe that the market is not crashing and that there are better options. I'm telling you, there are no better option than 5 million people that should probably consider selling their house and getting their equity out of it. The only difference between this market and 2007 is there are people who have equity and they're literally going to watch it slip away like sand in an hourglass. And you have the solution for them. We will educate you on that solution. Go to homeadvocates.io/event/. It's up until it's up or until I turn it off sometime today when I can get a chance to get in front of a computer. For those of you that are on the call, if you don't take advantage of it, if you have not joined, you're just straight up insane. I've got nothing left for you. Same for all of you that are in the coaching group about joining the Red Marketing Program. Antonio's video that we just did, I just got the numbers, Antonio. Your first video did 600 views targeted to the South Bay. One of my other things that I'm working on with the new marketing program got Google Analytics. It's actually indexed and on Google, this brand new website using this brand new format. And it's only been up for 1 week. So that's amazing, right? Getting page one, putting out the content, getting those numbers. And yes, the numbers will get better, Antonio. It's amazing for a first effort. I'm amazed at how I knew that Red Marketing would work. I've been using it for myself and for the company for a long time. It's the first time that I'm just taking it and applying it to a real estate agent or to a podcast or to my friend Eddie here in Vegas, his jiu-jitsu facility. It can be applied to anything. So it's actually quite great. The formula is great. And if you didn't watch yesterday's video, you're crazy. I explained how it works and it runs extremely well. And it's dirt cheap while I'm testing it. So those of you that didn't take advantage of it, I don't know what to tell you. You're crazy for not spending $100 a week on branding yourself and getting 600 eyeballs on you each and every week. It's crazy. There you go. That's everything. You're all up to date. Yes, Zillow selling everything. Yes, the market is crashing. No, these aren't things I'm thinking about. And there's still a 500-pound elephant in the room. And it's approximately 5 million people that nobody seems to know what to do with. And we just keep stretching this out. Keep an eye on that interest rate that they tried to inch up. It got to 3.5 and then panic set in and they dropped it back down. That is not the solution either. The solution is it's going to crash because you keep trying to hold the dam back. And that's what creates the crash. Michael Burry, Lee Honish, all the websites that are, or all the people you watch on YouTube, we all agree on the same crash. And we all agree on it for generally the same thing and then our own nuances as well. We're not a conspiracy theory group. We're people who've been in the industry for 30 plus years and we've watched the market trends. If you want to watch guys that are on CNN or Fox make analysis and tell you that everything's okay, that's because it's their job to tell you it's okay. Because it keeps you calm when the shit hits the fan. If you're a real estate agent or you're an investor, go to homeadvocates.io or just type in Home Advocates into Google and you will find all of our information. And you can join our program or learn more about us.